Britt's Picks is back. We are here with an update, and by we, I mean me. I am Britt, creator of the Style Shaker, a guide to cleaner, greener, ultimately better for you, makeup, skincare, and beyond. I try it out for you so you have a better idea of what to buy and what not to buy. I've tried thousands of products, and every couple of months or so, I update my top 20. I have a total of 11 changes, so over half of the products have shifted. 6 newbies, 5 are coming back into the picture because they've been on heavy rotation in here. So without further ado, let's dive in. Here we go. We're kicking it off strong with a new addition. If you like the Kosas Revealer Concealer, I do too. It's been on the list for a long time and it is currently getting bumped with the Iris and Romeo Concealer. This concealer is phenomenal. And I really don't say that often if you're new here. Those of you who are, you know. It's very hard for me to say that. Or it takes a long time, rather, for me to say it. So the coverage here is amazing. The staying power, I really don't have to set this, which is crazy. And the finish is a very natural finish. I just love it. I love it, I love it, I love it. New addition. Kicked Kosas out, which kicked Ilia out, so it's like, the concealers are just getting kicked. Next, I have finally found a shampoo and conditioner bar that I like enough to bring onto this list. These are the Super Zero shampoo and conditioner bars. These are for finer hair. There's plenty of information back on the site about these. I have really liked using them. I use them in conjunction with Evolve products as well. I still use those. But man, these are impressive little guys. The next is a swap from True Botanicals. It's a really great oil, their Pure Radiance Oil. It's been on the Britt's Picks list for, I don't know, at least 2 rounds. I really like it, and my skin likes it. But I have been reaching more for their Chebula Active Immunity Serum, or Chebula, I really don't know. I have to figure out the pronunciation. All I know is the serum, I like it because it's very mild. It's really good for sensitive skin types. And the key thing that I've noticed about this serum is that whenever I use it, if my skin is red or angry, I will put this on the night before, I'll give it a second, I'll put a moisturizer on top, wake up the next day, and it really calms my skin. I know a lot of products say that they're gonna do that. I've tried many of them. Several of them have not worked that well for me. This one consistently performs for my skin. Next, a kind of a little swap here. This is the Mob Beauty Cake Liner. It's in their compact, which are now they make biodegradable. They're incredibly eco-friendly products. The cake liner that I had up was black. I'm switching it to brown simply because that's the color that I've been using most recently. I love it because you can get a defined line if you want to, but you can also just blur it out if you want to. I'm just gonna a little touch up here. That's it. You just use an angled brush and then you can soften it with your fingers. It's so easy to work with. It's kind of dum-dum proof if you're like a newbie to makeup. Basically, it makes you look like you know what you're doing with makeup. It's very forgiving, but you don't have to be perfect and precise with it. I mean, do you ever? Probably not. I'm bringing back the Lawless palette. I love this palette. I still love this palette. You don't need to get the giant big one with all of the colors. They have a really good assortment of mattes and shimmers. I hardly ever use the shimmers. I have no idea why, but I use a lot of the apricot colors and the soft pink colors for summer. I've just been reaching for it almost every day when I'm not testing another eyeshadow, so I absolutely love, love, love this palette, and I've been using it more than the cream shadows that were previously on Britt's Picks. Another product that's coming back, I had a cream bronzer from Rose Inc. on there. I really do like it. I think it's really good if you don't want too much bronze. I feel like it's probably gonna be back on the list for winter. But instead, I've gone back to one of my all-time favorites, which is the Alima Pure Loose Powder Bronzer. Very forgiving. You can build it up to get really, really strong pigment, or you can keep it subtle. And this is one of the loose powders that's actually pretty easy to control. It's matte, there's no shimmer, it lasts. It's a really good workhorse if you need warmth and bronzer and you're not looking for something that's barely there because it shows up. New addition, very excited to say this, had the founder on my podcast, she's lovely. This is Once in a Pink Moon Air Element Aquarius Moisturizer. That's a mouthful. But this is from a brand called Pink Moon. There is an incredible backstory that I will link to in the description as well. This moisturizer, there's no scent. It's really great for sensitive skin. I've been putting it on every single day because it's really lightweight and yet very effective at moisturizing my skin. It's hot, it's humid, It doesn't leave a sticky kind of aftermath, or to the touch test, my hair can blow and it won't stick on my face. And it works well with every product that I've put on top of it. I'm a big fan. This is an oldie that never made it to the list, and yet I purchased because there was a sale. I got another one and I'm loving it. This has been a favorite of mine for a while in terms of the category for lipsticks, 100% pure, but I tend to love their matte lipsticks. Sometimes they're always out of stock actually in the mattes, but the cream lipstick that they have in Clover, it glides on. It gives a really lovely pink color. It's not too strong. It's not too dark. It's like right in the middle, which I absolutely love. It lasts, which a lot of the balms I've been trying recently just haven't been lasting for some reason for me. I love a balm, but I'm going back to the lipstick, and it feels moisturizing. Huge fan of that, adding it back onto the list, or adding it to the list rather. All right, we have two more. One is a brow product. It's from Anastasia Beverly Hills. You usually don't see this on clean beauty channels, I know. Is it like ticking off the clean beauty boxes? That's completely unregulated. So it's not the cleanest of the bunch, but I needed something to hold my brows in place. And this stuff, it's really good. I use it with a spoolie. I use very little and I don't fuss. I find the more I fuss with it, the more you'll see a little bit of like flaking, which is not a good look, I understand. Let it do its thing and it stays. It absolutely holds on better than pretty much any other brow product that I have tried thus far. Certain people have mentioned that this product can dry out. I haven't seen that and I've had it for quite a bit. Just close it tightly. I don't know, maybe that'll help. The last product that I want to mention to you is one that I can't believe I'm saying it. It's a blush. It's a cream gel blush from Say. It is their Dew Blush in shade Chili. Has a giant, beautiful doe foot. It applies so, so easily. It presses into skin quickly. Finish is natural. It just gives you a pop. You can use it anywhere on your face. I love this stuff. I am not a blush person. I am not a blush person. I've said it 1,000 times here. And honestly, I guess I can't say that anymore. This made me somebody who loves to wear blush. It's a really good multitasker. I just need it to not be in plastic. And they're doing their thing at Say. So keep up the good work. Take this out of plastic, put it in something better. Whatever that is, because I'm still learning what's better in the world of packaging. I'm not an expert there. You know what? There's one that I have to talk about, and it's a lip liner. And it's really good. So I'll just say this is a bonus. This is the Tower 28 multi-liner. I think they're kind of genius because, let's be honest, any lip liner could be a multi-liner. Now, does this have a different formulation? Probably. I haven't really compared it. This really is good. I reach for this pretty much daily after I put on a lipstick like I just did. I have shade Work of Art. It's a beautiful neutral. I didn't go lighter with the shade. I went a little bit darker for my skin color because I wanted to use this on the lid and see if it was multi-purpose. Absolutely is. I'm so close to bringing the Coco Crayons back from Air Perez. They're a little on the creamy side and run a little bit on me. So I think that has something to do with summer and humidity. I love them. I also love the Elate pencils. Honorable mention for both of those. I feel like I should do this for home products, lifestyle products, cleaner, greener. Why am I not doing that? There's so much to do. There's so much to share. What are your current favorites? I would love for you to share those in the comments below. Let us know why they're your favorites. Thank you so much for that. You can see all of this back on the site. By the way, there are some promo codes. They'll be listed back on the site as well. So you can get a little money back. You know what I mean? Thanks again for watching. Don't forget to hit the like button. I don't know why I said it like that. Don't forget to hit that like button. Subscribe if you're not already. Have fun browsing my new favorites. I mean, I'm loving them. See you back here real soon. Bye.